everybody, and welcome. Today we're talking about something very exciting for all you space simulation enthusiasts out there. The upcoming pre-alpha release of Kitten Space Agency in, and I quote, the coming weeks. As many of you know, KSA is a spiritual successor to Kerbal Space Program, independently developed by New Zealand-based studio Rocketworks, with a team that includes several former KSB and KSB2 developers. And yes, some of you might already recoil when hearing KSB2 mentioned in the same breath as Alpha Release, since the early access release of the second official Kerbal game was less than stellar and still cost 50 bucks. But as stated multiple times in the past, Kitten Space Agency will not cost you a dime. Instead of selling the game, Rocketworks want to finance KSA through what they call contributions. How that is going to work exactly is not yet known, but make sure you're subscribed to this channel because once I know, I will let you know. And there is already an entire video about that topic, I'll link it in the description. The purpose of the first pre-alpha release is going to be validating assumptions and improving the foundations. So I think it's wise to manage all of our expectations. Whatever they're going to release, it will not be a finished game, even less so than KSP2 in its initial public form. But then again, it doesn't claim to be yet. As I talked about in previous videos, there will be a rudimentary game loop, but no vehicle editing. And from what the developers told me, they will already count it as a win when the game launches and doesn't crash immediately once they move from their very small circle of PCs to a much larger install base. Will there already be kittens? Probably not as playable characters, but Rocketworks CEO Dean Hall did show off a first animation for one of the titular critters. I have to admit, I'm not sure how I feel about that 3D feline. It looks off somehow, but let's not dwell on that. Instead, let's talk about how you, yes, you, can help make KSA a better game by grabbing the first release and tinker around with it. Here are 5 ways you will be able to make Kitten Space Agency better. And we start things off by brutal testing. Rocketworks is building KSA on their own custom framework called Brutal, all caps, which is the technological foundation of the game. It is designed to avoid the performance bottlenecks that plagued Kerbal Space Program and also to avoid the Kraken, how game-breaking bugs came to be known. KSP was built with the Unity engine, and its creator Harvester, who is also listed as part of the KSA team, attributes a lot of the Kraken strikes on shortcomings of Unity. Contrary to how any game engine works, not just Unity, Brutal gives developers more direct control over core capabilities. Rocketworks CEO Dean Hall explained that the team wants to find out in an early stage of development if their big investment in their own framework paid off. They also want to get feedback on the data structures they used for all elements within KSA, like planets, parts, and vehicles. Through the pre-alpha release, the developers hope to validate their technical approach as early as possible to ensure these foundational elements are sound and to find out if their design assumptions were correct, because a bad decision at this level could affect the game for decades, as we have seen in Kerbal Space Program. Your input will help ensure that KSA's core simulation, terrain rendering, and physics systems are robust and deliver the performance that we had hoped KSP2 would give us, but didn't. But if you are someone who doesn't pay attention to a game's performance or who has no interest in what goes on under the hood, you still might be able to assist by hunting bugs. No software is bug-free. Especially an early alpha, or rather pre-alpha in KSA's case. Despite the claims that the Brutal framework hasn't encountered any Krakens yet, some bugs are going to be inevitable. And speaking from my own experience, when you wrangle with a piece of software long enough, starting from its infancy, you get so familiar with its quirks that you will miss a couple of things a fresh pair of eyes would immediately classify as a bug. That's why the developers are intentionally putting this early version out to identify issues players could run into. Early feedback allows the team to pivot and change things more easily than if major problems were discovered later in development. By actively playing and reporting what breaks down, you'll be directly contributing to a more stable future game. Even if there is not much to do yet in Case A, whatever you can do, you should do. Kind of like playing as if you're the incarnation of Murphy's Law. I am sure Danny2462 is going to have a field day coming up with all kinds of absurd ways to break the game, and that's going to be a lot of fun to watch. Speaking of fun, another reason for trying out the alpha is to find the fun. Currently, Rocketworks is still mainly focused on building the technical foundation described by Dean Hall as eating our vegetables before we look at dessert. They are side-eyeing the fun right now, as he put it in an interview he did with me a couple of months ago. Link to that is in the description. Key design decisions such as the balance between realism and accessibility, for instance, whether vehicles should maintain rotational momentum during time warp or if you can adjust attitude while time warp is active, are still being worked on. While the developers want players to learn orbital mechanics rather than just pressing a button, they're keen to find the fun as quickly as possible, as they put it. Your feedback on gameplay mechanics, UI decisions like the new transfer planning tool, the scalable and movable gauges, and how seamless transitions really feel will be crucial in shaping KSA into an enjoyable game, not just a glorified tech demo. Me personally, I had the most fun in Case P designing my vehicles in the editor, which is something I won't be able to do in KSA yet, but if you are somebody that likes to tinker with the game itself, you can do so if you start modding. Remember when KSP2 promised to deliver a modding API to hook into and modify any part of the game? Well, that never came to pass, unfortunately. While there isn't a dedicated API for modding officially mentioned for Kitten Space Agency, modders will be able to change the game from day one. At first, this will probably be focused on modifying configuration files like adding your own celestial bodies or modifying the existing ones. From what I have seen in the KSA Discord server, people who want to create their own planet packs or solar systems will be able to hook into the same systems as the developers themselves are using. For instance, all of the shaders are compiled at runtime. And if you are familiar with C#, you will probably be able to modify KSA on a very deep level. In public statements, Dean Hall explicitly called modders the most qualified people for improving the game. The upcoming pre-alpha release is a direct appeal to the modding community to put that to the test. And if you are a modder, you will be able to make your mark early on that way. I mean, if you look at the KSA development team, there are already two very prominent names from the KSP modding community on the roster. Lynx, who did the fantastic Parallax mod and who is working on terrain in KSA, and Blackrack, who introduced clouds to KSP and also worked his magic on KSP2. But I mentioned earlier that the game is going to be officially free, and this leads me to my final and maybe most important item. Because if the plan for KSA works, you will be able to shape the future of game funding. Studio closures, mass layoffs, games priced at 80 bucks standalone and at the same time dumped into game passes for scraps? The gaming industry is in absolute shambles right now. And how things were done up until now might no longer be a sustainable way of doing business. This and a couple of other things have pushed the KSA developers to set their hopes on an unconventional funding and distribution model. While we're talking about a pre-alpha right now, even the full game will be free. At least, that's the current plan. So, how are the developers going to be paid for their hard work? Well, they hope to finance the game by what they call contributions. What exactly those are and how they differ from simple donations is so far unknown, but the team at Rocketworks want to have this set up already for the pre-alpha release. While still unproven, it is at least something new, a departure from the old way of funding game development. Your willingness to engage with this model, provide feedback on its viability, and actually contribute if you enjoy what KSA has to offer, or if you believe in what it might become later on, will directly influence whether this new approach to game development can succeed. Ultimately, the first public pre-alpha of Kitten Space Agency is a strategic move to involve the community early, building trust through transparency. It's a chance to literally help build a game from the ground up with the help of your feedback. But we don't know how the developers will collect this feedback yet. Will there be some kind of public forum, a type of bug tracker, or just another channel on the KSA Discord server? All of these questions need answers before the pre-alpha release can be put into your hands. But as I said in the beginning, we're apparently talking weeks now, not months. Let me know in the comments if you are willing to endure a very unfinished gameplay experience in order to help hammer it into shape for something greater down the line. And if you want to help me out because you enjoy these types of videos, please consider joining my Patreon or signing up as a YouTube channel member. For a small monthly contribution, you get perks like watching all videos completely ad-free over on Patreon. And if you choose one of the higher tiers, your name will show up here, together with all of these wonderful people. Thank you so much for your support. I've also turned on YouTube's super thanks if you want to help this channel out that way. What are you most excited to contribute to in KSA? Or what worries you most about this project? Do you think we will be able to get our hands on the pre-alpha before the end of summer? Once again, let me know in those comments down below. And also let me know what you think about that first kitten character from the beginning. Cute and cuddly? Or straight to the litter box? I mean, there are some totally not cute cats out in the real world. So who are we to judge?
If you enjoyed this video, please subscribe to my channel for more and follow me on my social thingies. The links are in the description. Thanks for watching. Goodbye.